Alright you guys, welcome back. So I have a little tiny mini Aussie here. He's probably 30 pounds, something like that. He's little. But I'm going to show you how we're going to do his little haircut. I'm going to take this out. He's doing really good, but he is definitely like shy. So we're going to be moving a little bit slower. I'm going to take this down a little bit. I clipped his head a little bit higher up just in case he was snappy for nails, which he was not, so we're good. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do these paw pads. I like to go ahead and get the paw pads, and like I kind of work from the bottom up on these kind of dogs. So we just did, like I said, the nails, and then, you know, we do the feet, and then I'm going to go up and do the legs, and then we'll do the booty underneath the belly and up until the front. But he's probably not going to, I'll maybe trim a little bit of this stuff on his chest here, but he's going to be mostly natural. Okay, so feet are trimmed. Good job, baby. You're doing good.
But now he's so shy. I'm just a shy boy.
Brushing it up. Just going to trim in between these toes. The foot down. And we're going to trim around in a circle. This is a nice, cute little foot. Good job, Tucker. Good boy, buddy. Okay, in this hawk area, he really doesn't grow a lot. Just brushing that up. He reminds me so much of my mom's dog. Pitbull that is just as nervous. But he acts like the same. Like, I don't think he would ever hurt anybody. If anything, he just thinks everybody's gonna hurt him. Okay. And we're gonna do the same on this one. And the toes. The other day about wearing the mask for the entire groom. For stuff like that, I don't know how you wear a mask, because I'm always like blowing hair away and like that kind of thing, you know? So I mean, I do wear it for a lot of the groom, but to me it's kind of impossible to wear it for the whole thing. Okay, so now I'm gonna work up to his britches on this side. Go ahead and have my arm ready underneath. Make sure we're on a 10. We're going to lift this leg. He already kind of knew the gist. He was already lifting it for me. Good job, little dude. Good job, little dude. You just gotta trust me. You're doing so good. Okay, that was all I needed to do on this side, so I'm going to reclip. Because I need to do under the nub. These little nubby guys are so good. I'm not even sure if he has a tail. He doesn't at all. It's just like hair. Sorry. So I'm just going to shake out. Sorry. He's like, God. Excuse me. Okay, so I'm actually going to switch you to the other side. So you can see the booty. So let's move you on over. taking our friend to the home.
I'm just going to bring him towards me a little bit.
Just be aware if they have balls for this. Especially because some dogs are like some men that have some very dangly ones. That main line set. Sorry, I'm gonna block you a little bit for a second. Just wanted to go in between those legs and make sure that looked good. We're just blending down into that back leg back here. These don't need to be like super short, we just need to look neat. Okay, so we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. I go straight down in the middle. Up again, being aware, especially if you have an unneutered male, it's not our job to neuter them, so let's be careful. All right, and I'm just going to comb it all in again. Grab my straights again. Go ahead. I'm just gonna brush it up. I did this on that palm booty too, so it's kind of honestly, literally, it's the same haircut. Just being honest with you. That's one thing about grooming is, like, this is the same thing I would do on Luna's butt, and like I said, Pomeranian. This would be the same thing for that. Aussie, obviously, she's a pea. Sorry, I'm so sorry. Last thing I should be doing is misgendering you. I apologize. Because I'm a nervous guy anyway. Calling me a girl now.
Listen, there's nothing wrong with being a girl.
Alright, so. There's that. Now, you can always go in and texturize if you're a little, especially if you're nervous with the big shears, like the straights. I'll just go in and blend any harsh out crotch lines. Just let that all blend together really nicely.
Thank you. definitely too stiff to brush out. You know, it kind of gets, once it's like a hard lump, nervous with the dryer around his head, so I kind of figured there would be some, actually, let me move you back over so you can see what the fuck I'm doing, sorry.
The rest of you should only need to be on this side for, so.
You guys know how it is when you get one that's a little nervous. Just want to make sure he's comfortable as a priority. I can just kind of see this, how this is hanging by his knee here. That was the stuff I was trying to fix while he was up, so. Just do that. Good job, buddy. Just hitting all this stuff with the thinners. Anything that is like a point like this here? Can you see that? We're just going to take that point off. We want it to look round and smooth. Okay? Good job, little dude.
He's a good little dude. A little good dude, I'll do it. Yeah, you're like Murphy. Yeah, he's like a little dude.
He's a good boy.
Yes.
He's a little dude, huh? Okay.
again. We're gonna work our way up. So we're gonna start with paw pads.
Make sure we're set on a 40. Actually, you know what? Didn't hurt to go ahead and do the 10. Well, it was already set on it. Again. Good job, dude. Okay, go. Good boy. Such a good boy, dude. Same thing we're doing on the other side. We're just gonna brush all this in. Grab our long straights. I'm gonna trim it down. You know what? We should have the feet first. Don't follow me. Like the blind leading the blind. I'm just kidding. No, we didn't even do paw pads. Hello. That's what happens when you get off track like that. You start jumping around. Should have just gone with what I was doing. Type of dogs to go ahead and get that nice and short underneath. You can kind of go up on this area there in between the paw pads. I almost feel silly uploading anything but story times now. Story times are what?
Where's that? Y'all are like, eh, about the grooming these days. Just kidding. I know a lot of y'all still like the grooming, but I think most people like the story times at this point.
Okay. So again, just trimming in between these toes. You put the foot down.
By the way, you can use a comb, but sometimes it's harder to get the comb through it, and I feel like the brush gets out any undercoat a little better. See some of this on this side? See, that's why we always go across. So, same thing. Again, being aware. I can't tell if he's neutered or if he just has, like, saggy balls. But I can, like, he has, like, it's worth being aware of. I can feel something there. He's either not neutered with tiny balls, or he has big balls and he got neutered.
He still has, like, a sack bun from it. Not sure which. Not something I asked about.
For grooming, now when we did doggy daycare, we did have to, well, the professional doggy daycare I worked at, we did make sure that the dogs were spayed and neutered after, I think we required after 5 or 6 months. So for that we did ask, but you know, grooming, not gonna be asking if the dog's neutered. Unless maybe that's something you need to know. I don't find that it affects the grooming process. Maybe the females in here gotten to a few clients and been working on dogs and had the female go in to eat. Harsh line, like if I cut like this and there was a harsh line there, you would go like different, you could either go like this way, or you could do like a vertical, you could do a diagonal, whatever, but you're just going to want to go an opposite way of where that chop line is, okay? Okay, so that's how you're gonna fix a lot of those little oopsies. If you're gonna be a dog groomer, you gotta know how to fix an oopsie. Yes, we are moving on, working on moving targets.
Check the back of this little foot here.
if I don't trim the arms, I like to at least get back by this little pad here just to keep that nice and close. So that way it doesn't get mud and stuff in it. Alright, good job, babe. Good job. Okay, let's put some of this stuff up. I'm gonna throw a little neck piece on him. We got little necktie kind of things right now. They're super cute. Since he's wearing orange, give him the orange one.